Greece is clearly at the crossroads. It is a test for the system.
The Europeans are not really intending to save Greece. In fact, they like it. The more Greece hurts,
recovery will have to wait.
A wake-up call for Greece and the euro, as the threat of a contagious debt crisis conflicts with the moral hazard of bailing out a nation with bad fiscal habits. Here on the steps of the nation's finance ministry, textile workers from the north of Greece who haven't been paid in a year have come overnight on a bus, many with just a few euro in their pockets, to block traffic. This textile worker has three children and can't pay her bills, and is ashamed that she can't give her college-age child any pocket money.
Και τώρα είναι κλειστά. Δεν θέλω να συνεχίσω.
On the docks of Piraeus in Athens this same day, dock workers are angry.
No have work, nothing. You see? No have work.
Many here are protesting. The company they work for, which has changed its name after filing for bankruptcy and is now refusing to pay their wages.
We don't have any weapons to make something like a war.
Greece is dealing with a confluence of bad news.
So Greece faces the Herculean task of getting its financial house in order, and this is going to be a problem for a number of reasons. It's got a huge budget deficit, high public debt, it's in a recession, faces unemployment numbers of 10% and higher, it's got rampant tax evasion and a bloated public sector.
There has been an issue about the ability of the political system domestically to deliver reform. On this occasion, it must pass that test.
But all of this comes to light amid a numbers game Greece eventually ended up losing. How did it get to this point?
Once we are in a recession, the imbalances became apparent. The markets all of a sudden picked on Greece. They realized that it could be a new subprime problem.
When this government took over in October, I went to Brussels and said, look, the deficit is not 6% of GDP, it's 12.5. At that point, this government should have presented a timetable explaining to people how we're going to tackle the problem. So we lost precious time.
Greek officials say political infighting led to conflicting methods of accounting for debt, military expenditures mainly. Ultimately, there was internal political struggle over whether or not to even join the euro.
There were some other stuff that indeed were some tricky stuff that everybody was doing.
As in most democracies, you know, we have good and bad governments, but here bad governments vastly outnumber the good ones. And this is why we face the problems we face now.
But how far back does the numbers game go?
Greece did not enter the euro area by fixing the statistics. This is a big error. And it is an error, a conscious error, committed by the center-right government together with Eurostat.
3% was consistent with the entry into the EMU, and so it is a lie to suggest the opposite. It is a lie to suggest the opposite.
Greece engaged in back-end derivative swaps shortly after joining the euro. This meant they could essentially borrow huge amounts of money without having to count it as debt, and essentially delay their debts even longer, a technique many here say is par for the course in Europe to lessen the impact of currency devaluations.
The swap was fully consistent and compliant with the Eurostat rules, was performed by many other countries in the European Union, and did not hide anything.
Hiding debt. Did Greece
hide? Oh, come on. Do you want to make comparisons to look what other countries have done? Is it why hiding debt?
Getting into the Eurozone in 2001 meant Greece would give up its drachma and have a chance at the good life of the Eurozone. That meant completely converting from a government-run, inefficient economy to a privatized economy. The problem is that transition has never fully happened.
The public sector is very inefficient. The government does not even know the number of employees it employs.
Judging the entry into the EMU, I think for Greece it was a very, very substantial economic success.
Many on the street, though, think joining the euro was a bad idea.
Plastic bottle of water, before the euro came in, it was like 50 drachmas. So the euro came in and it was 50 cents. And that's like 170 drachmas. So it was a funny thing that people, you know, didn't really realize that, you know, the devaluation. It was the same number, it was 50.
Okay, maybe the kind of living is better, which is not exactly the truth, but we have raised the cost of living to that of the European Union, while the salaries have not raised to that level.
While prices converged with the EU, wages did not. And while it is true many Greeks make 2 months extra salary and have effective retirement ages in their late 50s, wages are low. A highly inefficient and enormous public sector encourages an extremely stifling bureaucracy, creating a nearly impossible environment to open a business or get licenses.
The public sector ends up putting obstacles on the private businesses in Greece.
To open a new firm in Greece, you need about 49 licenses, which is a global record.
Australian-born Greek Nicholas Geronimos has invested about 5 million euros in Athens businesses, including a popular hostel. He bemoans the bureaucracy that stifles business.
I mean, I'm horrified, but I see it every day. You know, going down to government offices, having to get one stamp on a piece of paper, and then going through 10 different stages of getting a stamp on a bit of paper and hitting blocks along the way. It's very frustrating, and it certainly makes it difficult to do business in this country.
He's unsure about the long-term potential for his businesses in Greece if the government doesn't attack the problem quickly.
The population took the public sector as given as well. They think it's the sacred cow that gives the milk, and somehow they disassociate themselves from the public sector. The public sector is there to provide privileges to people, but they don't feel they have obligations towards the state.
This imposing infrastructure has kept foreign capital out of Greece. There are only 7 golf courses in all of the country, compared to hundreds in other European countries. It's an area ripe for growth and indicative of the challenge ahead. Compounding the problem is tax evasion that contributes to a 30% shadow economy. In the upscale area of Athens called Kolonaki, many doctors only claim a tiny fraction of their income. Greece also faces a growing crisis over pension reform. At the leading edge of this issue, the fact that many Greeks retire in their late 50s. Many here worry they will lose their early retirement benefits. And for self-employed people like taxi driver Marianos Nikolavinis, who is set to retire this year, the reality is already here. Business is down and taxes are up, he says. He'll be working for at least 2 years longer than he had planned. The question in Greece is whether the austerity measures the government will take will be enough, and harsh as they may seem on the ground, whether Greeks will stomach them.
To me, the question mark is, will they take strict enough measures to persuade the market that they mean business?
It's going to be extremely difficult. I wouldn't like to say impossible, but I think the chances are certainly less than 50% that Greece will be able to put in place the required fiscal tightening.
The test is for the government to be able to pursue a strategy which redefines the noisy televisual strikes to indicate to a domestic as well as to an international audience that Greek opinion is actually changing and is prepared to countenance some serious domestic reform.
In the ancient city of Eleusis, today called Elefsina, an hour's drive from Athens, industry is key. Refineries and cement plants and a dock where 3 submarines commissioned by Germans sit abandoned over a dispute over quality specs, and workers sit angry. We're very worried about our future, this worker says. The government has not helped us. It is in this town where thousands of years ago, philosopher kings were initiated into the ancient rites called the Eleusinian Mysteries, honoring Demeter, the goddess of the harvest and social order. Centuries later, Greece is looking for kalokouragio, our good courage, as it faces a rebuilding of that social construct if it will reap another harvest. How fast that reconstruction goes will determine the fate of not only a nation, but the financial stability of its euro neighbors.
No member of the euro area can permanently live beyond its means. In other words, either you get your debt under control or your debt starts controlling you. Thank you.